Hello everyone, welcome back. Today's topic is the types of isolation. We have already discussed one question from CSIR in December 2017, which was based on the temporal isolation. So let's discuss the types of isolation. So the reproductive isolation is divided into the pre-zygotic isolation and post-zygotic isolation. So today we are going to look upon the pre-zygotic isolation. So the first one is the geographic isolation. Second one is ecological isolation. Third one is temporal isolation, which we have already discussed. Fourth one is behavioral isolation, and fifth one is mechanical isolation. So the first one is geographic isolation. As you can see in this picture, this is one species and this is another species, and they both are separated by a geographical barrier, which is a mountain. So in case of geographical isolation, a population is split apart by a physical barrier such as the river, ocean or the mountain range, etc. And the next is ecological isolation. Here you can see, although the two species they present in the same region, but they adopt different habitats. Okay, so in this case they fail to interbreed or they fail to mate each other and they isolated. And the third one is temporal isolation. We have already discussed that in this type of isolations, the populations, they do not interbreed with each other because they reproduce at different times. That means the breeding seasons are different. You can see in this picture, there are two species of frog. So this is the mating activity in the y-axis, and these are the times where the mating occurs. So for wood frog, the mating period is from March to April, and for leopard frog, it is for April too. What is ecological isolation or habitat isolation? So as I said, it occurs when two species that could not interbreed because the species live in different areas. That means they adopt different habitat. They acquire different habitat. For example, in India, both the lion and tiger, they exist and are capable of interbreeding. However, the lion lives in the grasslands and the tiger lives in the forest. That means both the species, they have different habitats. By living in different habitats, the two species will not encounter one another. Each is isolated from the other species. And this type of isolation, when organisms of the same range but do not come across one another because they are eating different foods, living in different habitats, or are mating in different areas, are called the ecological isolation or the habitat isolation. And the next is mechanical isolation, that is also called as the chemical isolation. So this type of isolation that occurs when different species are isolated by their mechanics caused by the structures or chemical barriers that keep species isolated from one another. For example, in flowering plant, the sap of the flower will tend to mate up with a natural pollinator. Plants that do not have the correct sap for pollinator will not receive a pollen transfer. And the next is behavioral isolation. It is a type of isolation in which two allopatric species do not mate because of different in courtesy behavior. What do you mean by courtesy behavior? The courtesy behavior is the signals or the calls or the songs they adopt, they use, the pheromones that are released. If they are different, they will not mate with each other and then they are isolated. So the behavioral isolation refers to the fact that many species perform different mating rituals that are performed. This is a common barrier between animals. So you can see in this picture there are three types of birds. So the calls or the songs pattern are totally different, so they will not mate with each other and they isolated. And in this case, this is also an example of temporal isolation where the mating activities of different species of frog are totally different. So this is all about the types of pre-zygotic isolations. I hope it will help you. Please do subscribe and share with your friends. Thank you.